stick out tonight。 大家好，酒香巷子深，红酒套路真。你是喜欢阿尔帕西诺还是施瓦辛格，本身呀是个口味问题，但每当别人问起你最喜欢男演员是谁时，你就不得不承认，回答前者就是比后者逼格要来得高。葡萄酒呢，同理，虽然每个人的口味不尽相同，但是呀，你要是说你喜欢修饰感没那么强的酒，喜欢度数低的酒，就是充满怀旧意味的一件事。所以说在餐厅里点酒怎么点，就成了葡萄酒初级爱好者必修的课程。
亲爱的，今天是个美好的日子，咱们点支葡萄酒庆祝一下吧。
好啊，都听你的呗。
服务员，
二位好，这里是我们的酒单，
谢谢你，
看一下今天晚上点哪支酒呢？
哎，不用，你来介绍一下你们有什么葡萄酒吧。
好的，先生，是这样的，我们的这里葡萄酒呢品种丰富，白葡萄酒我们有 Riesling、Pinot Gris、Chardonnay， 还有 Sauvignon Blanc。 我们的红葡萄酒呢有 Shiraz、Cabernet、Cabernet Franc， 还有 Merlot。 不知先生您对哪一支最有兴趣呢？
Cabernet。
哎呀，真是尴尬了，每次想为心爱的妹子点杯酒的时候，和服务员总会问那么一句，请问您需要点什么，就不能直接给咱们推荐了吗？其实啊，这个也不难，即便呢你是对葡萄酒几乎一无所知，但是点杯酒的能耐咱还是得有的。想要表现得像个行家，谈论葡萄酒的时候呀，最好加几句行话，比如说你喜欢新西兰产的长相思，那你是更喜欢度数低的白葡萄酒，口感呢偏酸，富有矿石气息，果香还浓郁。说到红葡萄酒嘛，澳大利亚产的希拉子很不错，甚至呀有果酱般浓厚的口感，而法国波尔多产的赤霞珠呢则单宁偏重，虽然说它入口有微微的发涩，但是人体的口感却是非常的丰富。一旦呀你学会了用这些品酒词，你会发现之前自己喜欢喝的葡萄酒都变得洋气了。
又是果酱味，又是矿石气息，可是我怎么闻到了巧克力的味道呢？
你吃。
谢谢。
其实啊，我对葡萄酒的了解可不只有这一点点，只要一看这个酒瓶子，我就知道里面装的是什么东西。你看，
哎，先生，
就像这一瓶酒，产自西班牙，气泡酒，特别适合像你这种甜美可爱的女孩。
哎呀，亲爱的，你真棒，什么都懂。
这个对于我来说不难，只有经常喝葡萄酒的人才能辨别得出来。亲爱的，试一下。
真的好好喝，而且好像酒精度也都不高。亲爱的，真棒，真的。
你干嘛呢？
你干嘛呢？
抢我葡萄汁。让你再抢。
如果你真的有自知之明，就千万别装，我们懂的人呗。其实每家餐厅的侍酒师呀，他们都对菜单上的每一款葡萄酒了若指掌。
给我来一杯你们这儿最便宜的红酒。
Sorry, what?
Cheapest.
Cheapest?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
That'll be $6.
Okay, okay.
Cheers, buddy.
如果呢，约会的对象在现场，你不方便向侍酒师明说出价格，不要犹豫，直接呢在酒水单上指出你要的那一款酒。这么一来， 你看起来就像一个敢于冒险的葡萄酒专家，总是对新的口味跃跃欲试。
先生，美酒。
谢谢。亲爱的，美酒配佳人，好酒配佳肴，你今天一定饿了吧？
哎，你还说呢，我从中午到现在都没有吃饭，都要饿死了。
那我们一会儿点点好吃的。
好的。
服务员。
先生，请问一下，您今天晚上点些什么菜呢？
来个水煮鱼片吧，辣椒可劲放。
这个没有。
那来一个大闸蟹吧，大闸蟹好吧，黄多高肥，哇哇好吃。
这个也没有。
大闸蟹也没有，那给我女朋友来个甜口吧，来个拔丝地瓜。
先生，这个真没有。
你们这儿什么菜都没有，开什么店呢？
先生，我们这儿是西餐厅。
葡萄酒配佳肴，可真是大有讲究，其中的门门道道还真不是我这半瓶子墨水能跟你们晃出来的。哎，给大家请了一位高人为你们解答，走，边吃边聊。今天是第一次来到康铎酒庄，这一次啊，我真的觉得非常非常的兴奋，因为马上就要见到传说中的 Zack 了。他不仅是一个葡萄酒专家，他更是一个美食大师，这也逼格太高了吧！居然骑着马过来接我 ，Zack。Hey, it's very nice to meet you. I hear a lot of story about you. Wow,
you take the horse too?
Yes. Wow. You've been scared of love. What it did to you. You don't have to run. I know what you've been through.
Hey, Zack. When we were riding through your property, I noticed that there were lots of grape wines and fruit trees. What are they?
Yeah, so here at Grotto Vineyard, we're actually quite diverse in what we grow. Variety of different fruit trees, especially citrus. We grow a lot of navel citrus, which is Fadians and Valencias. And we also grow some limes.
Limes.
Yeah, then further out the back, you would notice maybe we had some small plantings of almonds.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, so we trial a lot of different things, and this just allows us to fill out our wine range and do everything that we need to do in the vineyard.
What's the orange and lime trees for? For the wines or...?
The knob of the wines, they're sold separately as fruit, but, you know, when we were first starting out, it was an amazing addition to a drink that we created.
Ingredients?
Yeah, for the ingredients.
Oh, wow.
In one of our drinks, sangria.
It's a wine or...?
It's a wine. It's definitely a wine. Something we didn't come up with. It originates in Spain, but it suits this environment perfectly. It's beautiful and hot down here. It's easy to drink, nice and refreshing, and it tastes amazing. Do you want me to show you how to make some original sangria maybe from Spain?
So cool.
We'll make some sort of a traditional sangria up right here if you'd like.
Can't wait to try.
You want to start with some fruit, always makes it pretty interesting, and we want to muddle that.
What's that? This is passion fruit?
This is a little passion fruit.
Very little one.
Yeah, we'll whack him in there. Some orange.
Passion fruit, orange.
Some mint. We'll just rip that up. We want it to be a bit more sour. Chuck a bit of wine in there. So this is all stuff from there.
百香果，然后橙子，还有青柠。What's this?
So, secrets.
Secrets?
Secrets.
Really? Secrets?
No. Yeah. So, this is some butterscotch snaps.
I just told the audience that this is secret.
Well, then they'll figure out how to make it. They're not going to buy ours. But don't worry, we made it way easier. It's all good. And you want to add some red wine?
Red wine. Lemonade.
You want to muddle this up.
And mix all the ingredients together.
Yeah.
This one will get you drunk.
Yeah, so maybe in Spain they might not use lemonade, they might use soda water and sugar, but this is easier. And that's how you'd make a sangria in Spain. There's a million different ways to do it. I've been to many bars there, and
actually,
they all do it differently.
Sangria is just a name of the wine, it's not a...
It's not a, yeah.
It's not a brand
it's
name.
It's just a type of drink.
Ah, it's a type.
Yeah. So they drink it on the Day of the Dead, which is, say, Halloween.
Yeah.
From the 31st of October to the 1st of November.
Okay.
And it's a time when you celebrate life.
Mm.
Yeah. So
is it ready?
Is it ready to go? And sometimes you can garnish your cups and everything like that. But traditionally, sangria is quite dark and made with red wine. Perfect on a hot day.
It's really nice.
Yeah.
I mean, the flavor. It's more like a juice.
Yeah.
像水果汁一样，就是甜甜的，然后有一种橙子跟这个青柠结合在一起，味道是非常非常好。So you just told me this is the traditional way to do sangria. So what's the new way, what's the modern way to do sangria?
It's not really modern way, but it's just a way that we've just packaged it into one bottle, ready to serve, and straight away. And you can just pour it straight into your glass full of ice and enjoy it. And it's going
to cool.
That we've condensed the process and we've made it into our own bottle. So everything you see there is basically right here in this scene everywhere on this holiday.And it just is one of those things that promotes Day of the Dead. Celebrate life through death. It's, yeah, it's a really, really excellent holiday.
现在在我面前有这样的几款酒，接下来我有好几个问题要问一下我们的 Zach 先生，什么样的场景选什么样的酒来搭配这样的场景呢？For example, we have some scenarios. My friends wants host a party tonight. It's more like a...cocktail party, which one would you recommend for him or her?
Well, you can't get past these two.
These two?
Yeah.
The sangria.
Absolutely. They're basically cocktails. So they're sweet, they're fruity, everyone can drink them. You know, but if the party sort of gets maybe a little bit more upmarket, then you might move to red wine.
Yeah. Oh, cool.然后 Zach 先生给我推荐了这两款，也就是我们的桑格利亚。他说这两款呀是很适合年轻人 party 时候用的。第二个场景，如果今天家里人想吃一下牛排，换换口味，什么样的红酒才最适合呢？
Could be looking at any three of those red wines, to be honest.
These three?
Yeah. So you got the Merlot, the Cabernet, and the Shiraz. This is your more upper market choice, and the other two.Sort of middle of the range. The Shiraz always going to go the best with the steak. However, depending on what sides you're having, you know, Cabernet, Merlot, how many people?
Four and five.
Four or five? Get three bottles. Try all of them. See which one you like the best. Red wine, red meat.
Yeah, red wine, red meat. 红酒配红肉，其实啊，这三款红葡萄酒都是非常适合今晚的牛排的。如果说你的人数多。不如三款都试一试。那么下面一个场景，让我想想，我们来考一考 Jack 先生。如果说你想约心爱的妹子去一个昂贵的餐厅吃一餐晚饭，什么样的酒比较适合
？You can't get past the Shiraz.
This one?
Yeah, the premium Shiraz. Girls' taste change. Some girls might not like Shiraz.
That's true.
You have to sort of head just way back over this way to the sangrias, and it goes pop.It's a nice celebration, it's nice cool, it's fruity, easy to drink, so it's one of those things, you got to pick the wine to the person, yeah, you want to impress them, I guess you go to the big Shiraz.
Just take these two
to
get it.
Yeah.
Which one do you prefer?
Well, it depends on
Yeah.这是他们这边非常出名的一个 Shiraz， 当然啦，很多人可能会喜欢，但是你想约的那个女生可能就偏偏不喜欢 Shiraz， 所以说不妨这两瓶都带上，一个是 Sangria， 一个是我们的 Shiraz。那么接下来第四个场景，如果说大家一帮子朋友想搞一个 barbecue， 那么什么样的酒比较适合拿过去呢
？Well, I mean.Barbecue parties are hard because you don't know what they're going to be cooking. You don't know how long it's going to go on for. So I'm going to say all five.
All five?
Yeah, why not? So you've got your Cabernet for your lamb. You've got your Shiraz for your steak. Merlot goes with a bunch of different meats. And then once the barbecue is finished and you start partying, you've got the sangria. So
it's a party with theme. You can't go home with sober.
Yeah.
It has to be drunk.
Yeah.
葡萄酒里面的学问 真的是不是一天两天能揣摩出来的，所以说以后我还跟 Jack 先生多多学习才行。不知道你们今天学到了什么，但是我今天真的学到了好多。Jack, thanks for the day. You really told me a lot.
No worries at all. Thank you again for coming out. Excellent day.
Thank you very much.
Thank
you very much.
Yeah.
Hello, China. My name is Jing Li. I'm a member of the Parliament in the Legislative Council of South Australia. I've been here for more than 36 years, and Adelaide is really a beautiful place.Why? Because ever since my parents migrated over here, we have never left.
新年又到了，随着春节里，我祝大家新年快乐，万事如意，身体健康。要什么有什么，记得哟。如果你的梦想是要来澳大利亚的话，第一个地点就是阿德雷的南澳，欢迎你。总是
现在呢 ，Sam 先生给了我一个小小的考验，我要将面前这四道来自中国不同地方的菜系啊，和这四瓶酒搭配起来。这个对我来说还是相当考验的，因为你说这西餐吧，你还能想一想；这中餐呀，哇 ，Sam 这个难题给的我真的是措手不及。就这样吧，来看看 Sam 先生会对我的这个搭配做出什么样的评价。
You've been a great student.
Is it?
Yeah, you've done very, very well. Raisins have got lovely citrus flavors, and the citrus lifts the fleshy fish. It's a light meat, so you need something fairly light. So perfect choice. The tofu with the chili there, you need something fairly heavy to break down the chili. So capsaicin would be a good choice. The duck, it's got a fairly rich sauce, and Shiraz is a very rich wine. So they both go well together. They blend in well. And the tabernacle is a fairly light style, very lively. So with other seafood dishes, it's a very good choice for a red. So I think you've done very well.I probably couldn't have done this better.
Because you are a very good teacher.
No, thank you. For that, I'd like to share your dinner tonight. Do you accept
my pleasure.
Thank you.
Sam 先生说，今晚这顿饭他要请我。这瓶啊，天普尼诺，就让我来庆祝一下我这努力学校的成果吧。好了，今天我们就到这里了。那么下一期也希望你们继续收看我们的澳洲名探。拜拜。
Bye, bye, China.